Taj goes back to the corners. Good luck.
Abu Dhabi, make some noise. Uganda versus Morocco. Four rounds of boxing in the super lightweight division.
Looking forward to this. More so now after that build up, those ring walks, and the crowd interaction and plenty offered as well. There was a swagger, almost an arrogance about Iddi as he made his way to the ring, eager to get back into action after a bit of time out. And he's starting positively against Anas Hafiane, who made a stunning start to his career just a few months back, Barry.
Yeah, it's a lovely combination there from Hafiane. Nice little long 1-2-3, didn't get his foot too close. You see Iddi here, nice and fast with his attacks, but not quite as accurate maybe. Throws a little bit blindly.
Oh, but I was just about to say, Afian's got the old Mayweather low left hand, part shoulder roll defense, and there's only one Mayweather. It's a hard art to perfect, and there's a right hand got through, but back comes Afian with his own short, sharp right hand.
Yeah, just knocking a little bit off balance there.
You can see he's got the skills. Head up a little high in that low left hand, potentially a worry for Afian's backers.
It's a nice fast start though from both, isn't it?
Isn't it? Yeah, it looks like they're both responding to the atmosphere.
It's been more structure to the work here of Afian.
And exactly what Barry Jones wants to see, combinations there as well. Just missed with that left hook, come uppercut.
Yeah, good, well blocked, wasn't there, by Iddi.
A couple of times Iddi's not been a million miles away with that right hand, and just constantly drawn to the low left of Afian. Nice uppercut.
Yeah, it's a mistake by Iddi, wasn't it? Coming over that front foot, just not committing to the attack there and just leaving yourself exposed.
Yeah, there's just little mistakes from them both. There's just little openings from them both. Good left hook, follows it up with the right hand. More orthodoxy, I think, in the work and the approach of Afian.
Well, he's hitting the target. He's looking to, you know, every punch he's throwing, you know, there's thought behind it. Where Iddi, even though he's more a bit explosive, but just commits to it and throws, lets his hands go. Oh, good shot there from Hafiane.
Bit better with defence as well, wasn't it? It's quite upright. Certainly the more structured and busier start, this from Hafiane.
Yeah, he just needs it with his.
Oh, good left hand. Three or four left hands, and another one. Little bit of a push there, but a wobble of the legs as well from Iddi, who's gone down. Well, that's a big breakthrough at the end of the first round for Anas Hafiane. Well, it was an intriguing first round that got a statement at the finish. And it looked like it all started with a left hook and kind of finished with it as well.
Yeah, it did. And just the fact that he just says it just keeps his shape a lot better. So even under pressure, he got caught in the early rounds where, I think in the early part of the round, where Iddi was really explosive, but faster with his work come out. But you know, as the rounds went on there, just keeping your structure, punching inside your body frame, which he does have here. You see that nice little left hook. It was the shot caught him, then he pushes after. It's actually a really good heavy shot. A lovely. See the good right hand over the top, then the left hook follows. I think actually the right hand does most of the damage. Just chops, lifts the elbow, just chops down with it.
And he was putting his combinations together quite nicely. So that's walking up Iddi, no doubt about it. And what was a really competitive first round, but ultimately Hafiane getting the better of it at the end. So into the second, Hafiane will be looking to build on that. Iddi looking to work his way back.
Oh, good body shot there from Hafiane.
Yeah, he's looking to put it together. He's looking to stay in range.
You got to throw that right hand. When Iddi throws that jab, it comes back low. So every time he throws that jab, you got to throw your right hand straight away.
He's almost forcing Iddi's hand. He's again just slightly wobbled him with that. He was off balance, but the legs just did the jitterbug. There was just a little stutter step there from Iddi.
Oh, solid jab there from Hafiane as well.
Oh, he's putting his shots together now.
And the body shot, he felt that, Iddi.
Yeah, it was a left hook to the body on the back of the right hand. There's another slashing right hand. Bit of pressure now from Hafiane. Just a danger there with a trading left hooks up close.
But he keeps the right hand up high when he throws the left hook, so he's sort of protecting himself. So really good, going through the gears here, Hafiane, really good display here. Yeah. Controlled pressure.
Staying in range to throw shots too. Pushing him back, starting to bully Iddi. And starting to get through with some heavy leather. There's an uppercut. I think he's hurt him again. Iddi, for the first time, looking to hang on. Oh, that's a cracker. Another uppercut, followed by a second. He really is piling on the pressure now, Hafiane. This is a big round. I think the referee just asked Iddi if he was okay. He said yes.
See, he hasn't put his foot on the gas really either. You know, he's been really busy, hasn't stopped throwing punches, but he hasn't really loaded up with anything here, Hafiane.
And even the sort of shots that are coming back now from Iddi, there doesn't seem to be much on them. He's able to walk through it, that's for sure.
Well, technique is everything, isn't it? You can swing the shots in and wing them in with a, you know, with velocity and really put loads of weight behind the shot, and when you have really good technique, which Hafiane has certainly over Iddi, it means you can maintain that for longer. And it hits the tiger first, hits the tiger clean, and hits it often.
He's able to push him back. There's another body shot, goes through left hook. Looks like he might be wilting under the pressure now, Iddi. Thought he was going to go down there.
Nice left hook there, now combination as well there for Hafiane.
And Iddi trying to find some comfort up close, tying up Hafiane when he can. Oh, that jab put him, rocked him onto the back of his heels. Still 20 seconds to go in this second round. It's been a long, hard round for Iddi. He's been under a lot of pressure. And as Barry said, Hafiane looks quite controlled.
Oh, good work.
He popped a left hook there.
Yeah, look at Iddi though. A nice, lovely response there from Iddi. Showing a bit of grit here.
And it's Iddi looking to come forward at the end of the round, but he was under a lot of pressure, took many heavy shots. There were uppercuts, body shots, left hooks upstairs. There was a lot going on. There was a knockdown in the first round. There was actually more sustained pressure and bigger shots got through in the second.
Yeah, that was a harder round, that second round there for Iddi there. That was a real good display of controlled aggression there from Hafiane. Real good technique with his work. Only at the end of the round, he had to ship a few shots there off Iddi. Really showed loads of grit. But for the most part, the better technique, the work ethic as well there, the need to work better. Just everything was better. Everything's better there from Hafiane. Went through the gears. Just maybe, every now and again, could have sat down on some of the shots. He's a little bit taller at times. Just bend those legs a little bit more, get a little bit more weight, because he had the guy where he wanted him at times, and he could have just really just run some heavy shots in. But he's boxing really well, really well. Against a guy who really came to have a go in the first round, and at the end of the second round also, but really, he's put him in his place quite quickly.
Well, for most of the first round, it looked like he was going to be uber competitive, this, but as Barry said, Hafiane's just turned things around very much in his favour. Be interesting to see pace-wise, because he threw a lot. Although he looked controlled, he did throw a lot in that second round, and interestingly, Iddi was on the front foot at the end of the second round, and now he is trying to do the same again into the third.
But again, seeing that without that technique, just swinging the shots in, early in the round, when you're a little bit sharper and more dynamic early in the fight, you're going to get success. But when you're tiring, guy makes you miss like that, makes you pay for it.
Oh, big right hand and a second gets through from Hafiane. Tried with his own long right there, Iddi. He's given in everything, cheered on by a vocal crowd on both sides of the ring. Yeah, the counters are going to be there for Hafiane.
Just doesn't quite have that raw power, does he, Hafiane? He's landing some really clean shots, a lovely little spin move there with the left hook.
Yeah, he's just a bit too cute, a bit too clever for Iddi. But great credit to Iddi, sucking up the pressure, punishment, trying to come back with some of his own. Maybe that right hand is going to be the punch for Iddi. I don't know if Hafiane was off balance there.
He's got a good shot though.
Staggered back to the ropes himself, one way or the other. The African fans were on their feet. In fact, they've not sat down.
But that, and that gives him just a little bit of lease of life there. He made a bit more energy to push. Oh, it's a lovely shot.
A right, followed it up with a left hook. That was right on the button. He couldn't have thrown that any better. Oh, and he clipped him again, just on the end of the chin with a left hook, and down goes Iddi once again. But I think it was the left-right that he was hurt with previously. That's the combination that did all the damage. Referee asked him to go side to side. He's happy for him to continue. But that was a heavy, heavy knockdown.
But he haven't recovered one heavy shot again. I think he's going to be going to unravel again here. Iddi, there he goes.
Yeah, left hook, and he just slightly staggered into it. There's a short right hand. Again, he wobbles. You fancy just a punch or so away. Hafiane, if he can just create the space. He's wilting a bit here. Iddi again, he sags. Referee's having a good look. And he's put down again with a left hook. That was more through disorientation than anything else. He actually ended up with his head through the ropes. It was the wrong way. And when he came back into the ring, the left hook put him down for the second time in this. And what is that, third or fourth in the fight? Full stop. I've almost lost count.
But that second knockdown there, that was just I said in that round, that was just when he went through the ropes pretty much. But he's just in the replays here, shows some lovely skills here, spinning on the spin here, the counter, Hafiane there, again the cleaner work. But there's a combination of the left hook there, lovely left hook. And Iddi coming forward, again trying to force the pace, turned out to be really undoing in that round. And then when he did go down with that left hook at the end, it wasn't the heaviest of shots. The resistance already been beat out of him, if you will, almost. And the referee could have stopped that fight a few times in that round, I thought.
Yeah, it was almost just the accumulation of shots and sheer exhaustion and tiredness that was starting to tell on Batamazee Iddi. Not wanting for effort,
both
for desire and application.
This is the fourth
just not
and final
quite
round.
Good enough yet. And the technique of Anas Hafiane proving the difference between them. Well, into the fourth round. What compelling stuff this has been. Plentiful action, plenty knockdowns. And now the fans who've come here to follow Anas Hafiane just wonder if he can just put the exclamation on it.
There's a crunching right there, a right hand there from Hafiane.
You probably want to see him with the combinations, not looking for the one big shot, Barry. Well, that was no knockdown. There was a left hook to the body, but it kind of got entangled and it was a bit untidy and the referee was onto it.
The body shot there, though.
That definitely got through.
Just need to, again, just sit down and just punch it up here, Hafiane.
Right, then a straight right upstairs, then a left hook downstairs. So he's still thinking, even at this stage, what he's doing. Still a couple of minutes to go. The crowd have got right into it. Even though he's been on the wrong end of it throughout, Iddi, his fans have lent their support. Again, he was kind of punched through the ropes, Iddi. Oh, that's a huge right hand. And suddenly, Hafiane's in a bit of bother. I always wondered if those low hands were going to come to haunt him at some stage, but they nearly did there, but he took the shot well, firing back himself. What a remarkable turnaround that would have been.
Oh, look, good response there, though.
And that huge right hand, that wobbled Iddi once again. You can see the reaction in his legs every time he's hurt. What a compelling four-rounder this has been.
Nice. Cute little move there from Hafiane. But again, we've got to be careful, because coasting got him into trouble.
He's got a left hook, spins off, creates some space for himself once again. Just shows you there's just absolutely no room for complacency, overconfidence in boxing.
Yeah, sometimes you're coasting fights, you know, and all of a sudden you get yourself in trouble. You give a guy a bit of confidence, gives him more energy. Lands with a big shot, then all of a sudden then a guy who's flat on his feet, full of it.
Literally, one punch, one moment can be all it takes. And he had that punch in that moment, Iddi. He wasn't enough. And the crowd on their feet cheering towards the end of this one. What a pulsating four-rounder that was. Multiple knockdowns, all in favour of Anas Hafiane, who will win the fight comprehensively, but had to overcome a late, late scare at the end of that final round. You don't see many four-rounders like that, Barry Jones, and entertainment.
Yeah. It's really, really, really good, really enthralling, wasn't it? But again, though, it just goes to show, as you could see from early in the first round, that when you have good technique, when things start going wrong, things start unraveling, you keep your shape, it gives you such an advantage. And that's what it was at Hafiane. He structured a lot better with his work, and that's why he was hitting the target cleaner more often. And that's why, and I don't think he's a big puncher, I really don't. Because he's a clean, accurate puncher, he can get you into trouble.
Well, he certainly had Batamazee Iddi in trouble on several occasions, knocked him down repeatedly throughout the fight. Looked like he might be on the cusp of stopping, and particularly in that third round, it looked like he was just a moment or a punch away from doing it. But great credit to Iddi. His courage, his heart, his desire and his willingness kept him in the fight and saw him through to the final bell.
Ladies and gentlemen, before I read the scorecards, a round of applause for both gentlemen, please. After four rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecards. All three judges score it 40-33. All for your winner by unanimous decision. Fighting out of and representing Morocco, Anas Hafiane!
Yes, a convincing winner, Anas Hafiane. My goodness,
and a round of applause.